auctions on cruise ships, certainly fun and exciting, but some passengers now wonder if they were misled. A Harford County man is among them.
He's been sold or told the signature on a $12,000 print he purchased is a forgery worth nothing at all. I-Team reporter Barry Sims investigates.
When it comes to art, Richard English buys what he likes. The walls of his home are filled with paintings and prints. In 2006, he and his wife Tracy found a Salvador Dali print that became one of their prized possessions. They paid more than $12,000 for it.
We liked it. We thought it was pretty unique, and we're told that it was going to be an investment for us.
An investment that would grow in value. The Englishes bought the artwork during an auction like this one.
What do you take them for? This is basic.
They were vacationing on the Carnival cruise ship, Miracle. The English's print was shipped to their home. It arrived with plenty of documents, including a certificate of authenticity from Albert Scaglione, president of Park West Gallery in Detroit. That company runs auctions on major cruise lines. It's a multi-million dollar business.
They told me that it was appraised and that they had a provenance for it.
A couple of years later, English tried to sell the Salvador Dali print he purchased at sea. He sent photos to a California gallery. Their opinion, the artwork wasn't signed by Salvador Dali. English then had it inspected.
Here in the front.
In this videotaped examination, art experts Frank Hunter on the left and Nicholas Ducharne in the middle are also drawn to the artist's signature.
In the lower right-hand corner is a pencil signature, supposedly by Dali.
In their opinion, it's forged.
But with a fake signature, it's actually destroyed the value of the print itself, so it's worthless.
We spoke with Nicholas Ducharne in New York. He told us he believes the print is an authentic reproduction, but
when you looked at the signature, what did you think?
The signature is a forged one for me, in my opinion.
And why is that?
Because first, first when I discover it, I see four stroke. With the A separated from the D and the LI of Dali. And then I look at the D and I say, my God, the D has an inverse dynamic. Like instead of doing like this, it's like this.
The art industry is unregulated, so it's the last of the wild frontier.
Teresa Franks is at the helm of the website Fine Art Registry.
This is all a grassroots organization. We advocate for artists, we advocate for collectors, for galleries.
Franks is one of Park West's harshest critics. She arranged for that videotaped examination of the English's Dali print. She says the registry has received hundreds of complaints from other Park West customers who feel they got a raw deal at sea. She calls this a major consumer issue because buyers have no opportunity to really research the art.
You can't swim to shore, come back. Yeah, do your research, swim to shore, come back, and then buy. No, you can't do that. You're stuck on that ship.
It's blood sport for some to attack, you know, a premier company.
Park West attorney Robert Goldman calls it a cyber smear campaign. Park West has filed a defamation suit against Franks and Fine Art Registry.
That website is out to attack us, to defame us, to ruin our business.
Some Park West customers have filed lawsuits. They're trying to get class action status. This suit from Michigan claims the company deliberately and fraudulently misrepresented that the artwork sold was a good investment. Goldman claims Park West does a thorough background check on all of the art it sells. And as for the Dali,
this piece of art, is it authentic?
Yes.
Is the signature authentic?
Yes.
He says Dali signed his name hundreds of ways. There's even a book to prove it. And the Englishes have made a great buy.
Anybody that's willing to sit down with the Englishes and look at a signature for a few seconds and say it's fake, it's foolish, it's foolhardy.
But Richard English, who thought he was making a wise purchase, isn't convinced.
My head is spinning.
He doesn't think he'll ever see a return on the $12,000 Dali print, and he thinks this was an expensive mistake. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Barry Sims.
Richard English says Park West offered to replace his Dali print with other art of the same value. He's not interested. Teresa Franks and the Fine Art Registry filed a countersuit against Park West. The defamation cases go to court in February.